What's going on, guys? Welcome back to another episode of Industrialized. As you can see, I got a fancy schmancy new jetpack. Oh yes, this is a mechanism jetpack. It's been quite a while since I hit something like this. I don't think I've ever had a jetpack in any game, so or any of my Minecraft saves, so that's kind of cool. And you can see the bottom left, it has different modes. So you can have a regular mode, just you hit space and you go up and down, you let go and you go down and you hit a button. I have mine as numpad 5. It goes into a hover mode, and it's kind of like a really slow kind of creative type flying thing. Shift goes down, space goes up, and it's really good for building like things that are high, I guess. And you hit it again and it's disabled, so then you don't get any stuff with the jetpack. I usually leave it on regular, and it takes hydrogen. So I basically made another electrolytic electrolytic separator. Takes the water and separates it into oxygen and hydrogen. And I store it in these little tanks. And you just put the gas tank on the ground. Take the jetpack off your back. Chuck it in here. And it starts filling it up. Easy peasy. And then you can just wrench this to pick it back up. There we go. So let's put that back on here where it's supposed to go. And so yeah, that's the jetpack. And as you can see, I did figure out the villager issue I was having. It did turn out that, I think I put a note in the last video that I didn't have enough houses. So all I did was I made these little things over here. It's just a cobblestone block surrounded by 4 doors. And what are you doing? We also have a iron golem spawning over here. I already captured one in the safari net. So I guess that means I can do some sort of iron golem farm. But I've never done one. I don't even think I've ever seen an iron golem in any of my Minecraft games. So I don't even know the first thing about making an iron golem farm. So yeah, we'll have to look into that. And so I installed this other mod. It's it's like village info or something. You can see in the bottom left over here, it tells you how many houses there is. I have negative reputation because I've been killing villagers that I don't like. Like they don't have any good trade, so I kill them. So I have I have 13 villagers of a possible 13. So that's a really useful thing to have. And basically what happens is they spawn over here, they collect into this little pen, and I already have pretty much, this is all full of guys that I want to trade with. So like raw beef and emeralds, raw chicken for emeralds, actually has something else too. Gravel and emerald for 4 flint, what a ripoff! So yeah, I stick them over here in these little holes until I trade with them. And once they stop trading with me, then I bring them back to base and I drop them in my smeltery, and that gives me a tiny little fraction of emeralds. So yeah, don't really need to show you the smeltery, it's just there's some green stuff in it. I upgraded my crafting system a little bit. I added some drives over here on my ME drive, so I added some more 4K storage. I still have this one dinky little 1K storage left, but that's fine. I didn't want to build the thing to migrate the data to bigger storage. I will if I run out, but I'm probably more likely to add another drive. I added a crafting terminal here so I can craft stuff here. I find the exact crafter works a little better though. Like when you want to craft something and you shift click it into here, if you don't have all the items, it doesn't do anything. So it'd be nice. I like how the exact crafter, which I can go up and show you real quick because I have to go up here anyway. This is the exact crafter, and you know, like it automatically fills stuff in. So like, I don't know, this is probably something, yeah, I easily have all the stuff to build this, but yeah, it just fills all this in with ghost items. You don't actually have to have the items in your inventory to craft this, and it'll light up red if you don't have them instead of just not putting the thing in the slot. So I like this feature. So I tend to do all my crafting up here. I just kind of put that down there just in case I didn't want to come up here for some reason. And I put an access terminal here. So obviously I added some ME cable to my Ender IO bundle. You can kind of see it in the middle there. And you can see it there as well. And that just kind of runs in behind here. And I ran it over here in case I want to expand it a little bit. And then I also have under here, what are they? I think it's import buses. So it's an ME import bus, and that just kind of sticks in the bottom. Actually, let me just break this so it's easier to see. So these just stick in the bottom like this, and they basically just pull items out, and they import it into your AE network. I don't know, do you call them AE network or ME network? I tend to kind of use it interchangeably, so yeah. I don't know which one I'm supposed to use, so anyway, what else have I done? I think that's it for up here. Obviously, I removed the chest and stuff that was under here because I don't need it anymore. So let's go over to my mob farm. So many mobs around here when they shouldn't be around here. I do have sonic glasses, but I don't think I have them on me. So if I put these on, these are open blocks. What are they called? Yeah, sonic glasses. And they show you where all the sounds are coming from. So there's a creeper up there. That's not like a skeleton, but it's got a creeper icon. Unless that's maybe just a generic mob sound. So I'm going to use these to troubleshoot my mob farm when it comes to that time. So if we go out here. Holy. So basically, as you can see, I quarried out like a maximum default size. I don't know if it's quite maximum. It was at least maximum at 64 blocks on one dimension or one side. I think it was from here to here, 64. So it's close to 64 this way as well. Look, there's that guy up there. But I wanted to quarry this out because I was hoping that it would give me some better spawns up here. Which I've redone this as well. I pretty much ripped most of it down and I've redone it. I'll go up there and show you that in a second. So I made a little room over here. And I put my quarry here and it took like 2 days to quarry this out. It took quite a while. I had to put this door here, a little bit of a lag spike there. I had to put this door here because I was standing here. I can't remember what I was doing. I was like eating supper or something. I was watching the quarry run. And a creeper came down and he blew me up. And he blew up my chest full of stuff. And oh, it was a mess. I had hydrogen separators, hydrogen generators over here and stuff. And he blew one of those up. So I basically, can I fit up here? Yes. I made some of these mechanism solar generators, advanced solar generators. And it seems like one of those is pretty much equivalent to a hydrogen generator. So I made 4 of those and I put them up here and I used that to power my quarry. And it was actually really nice because it was silent. So I'm going to have to fill this in so it's not a big gaping hole. I'll do that sometime in the future. Let me go sleep real quick. Actually, can I sleep here? No, it's not nighttime yet. Let me go up here. Ow, 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 ow. So this is the new and improved mob spawner. I made these 3 wide now. And basically I made it so that, because the mobs are always getting stuck. So the pattern is probably not perfect, but I wanted to make it so that every intersection where a mob changes belts, they end up on the middle of the next belt. I'm gonna go sleep now for real. Ow, 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 ow. Damn it. What the f- No mobs up here? Okay. So basically, previously, these were too wide. And I found that the mobs would come along here, and then they would get stuck on the corner. Now, I don't know if that's going to happen or not. It's possible that it will still happen. But, I mean, for example, if a mob is coming down this belt here, he will land on the center of this next belt, and he will go right down the middle of this one, or down the center, whatever, and into the pit. So the pit is now 3x3 instead of 2x2. All the spawn pads are 3x3, and I did a little red stripe to match the base over there. And other than that, that's pretty much how this is going to work. I put these little blocks here because what I want to do is I want to put lights above each pad. What are the Ender IO lights? I haven't made any yet. I'm probably not going to do that this episode. But I want to put lights on here so I can turn the lights on and turn off the mob spawner whenever I want to. So that should be good. But what we're going to do right now is, let's see, I have a grinder here. And we're going to go start building a mob grinder down here. So we're going to get rid of the punji sticks. And we're going to replace it with a MFR mob grinder. Which I think... Problem is, I don't know a lot about the mob grinder. So hopefully I can do this properly. And I need to break these punji sticks. I don't know. Does this break them? I have a feeling maybe an axe would be faster. Nope. Why are those so difficult to break? Alright, let's fill this back in. So this is 3x3. So I want 1, 2, 3. I don't need this. Need these. So, get up in there. Okay. So mob's gonna drop in here. I think I need to do some sort of water break. I'm gonna worry about that after. I'm gonna build this first, and we're gonna see if it even works. Which is kind of hard to make it work until we put the roof on. So we'll probably have to put the roof on and then all that fun stuff. So let's see. I wonder how close I am to the outside because I'm going to need power. Actually, I think the outside is like right here. So outside there. I had to fight with this lava shaft too when I was building this or I was mining this out. So let's see. I don't know if the mob grinder has to be at ground level. I don't think it does. And that's backwards. Of course it's backwards. And it with the wrench. There we go. Does it have any settings? No. Just has a place to store some fluid. Which would probably be mob essence. Which I'm going to use in a later episode to feed back up to the mob spawner, and we're going to use the mob essence to spawn different mobs that we capture. So, I guess, let's see. Actually, I don't want this here. Do I want this over here? I think I can pick these to pick them up. Want this to be in line with the 3x3 room. So I'm going to put it over here. And it's backwards again. Alright, so that should do the trick. Hopefully, anyway. I mean, I could make the room bigger. But we're gonna roll with this for now. So let's see. I need power. I have tanks. I'm going to put the tanks like, maybe like this, maybe, and then, thing is, I think it outputs items Does it output items? I think it does. So I think what I'll do, I'm gonna have to go get another chest. All right, we're gonna cheat. Just put that like that. Put the items in there, and I guess the fluids over here, like that. I go like this, extract always. I don't think I have to do that. This probably extracts automatically. So now we need some power. So I can just basically, let's see, what's out this way? I don't know how far I have to go to get outside. Probably too far. That's obsidian, that's not a good sign. Probably should have planned my exit first before I started recording this. I know I can go this way. And by no, I mean I'm guessing. I can. Where's my shovel? The hell was that? Okay, I'm retarded, I guess. Let's see. I mean, it's a volcano. I didn't think it was that hard to get to the outside. This is what kind of the downfalls of solar panels. I think I'm way down here. This is the problem I'm having. I'm pretty much at this level. Would you go away? I mean, I could come out this way, maybe. It doesn't really matter where I go. I'm just trying to keep it simple. Let's go like this. Let's just go like down here. I heard a baby zombie, didn't I? SOB. Get out of here. Oh, I'm almost dead. Alright. So I'm going to dig down to this level. Gonna attack me when I jump in here.
Nope.
Okay. I find the jetpack makes it a little bit trickier to get around sometimes. Alright. Dig this way a little bit. Okay, we're right under the tank. So now, what I'll do is put power in the bottom. This, maybe? Try and minimize the requirement for the facade pieces because they can be a pain to make, and they can be expensive. Okay, it's nighttime. Damn it. Oh, yay. All right, so I'm just going to roll a 2 for the time being. We'll put one like here. That. And then actually, I could probably do one over here. I do have some kind of a big hitbox sometimes, so there we go. Put that like that. So that's good enough for now. That'll give us power. And it is indeed running. Okay, very nice. So now, I think we just have to close it in. Let's see. Items will go in there for now. Mob essence will go there. Power's coming. I think that's all I need. Just, I don't know if this damages me if I'm standing in there or not. Kind of don't want to find out. Should fill this back in. Oh, God! I wonder how good he is at pathfinding to me. Hopefully not very good. Think he could get all the way around here. Where is he even at? Like he spawned inside the wall. Greasy. I might have to fix that later. Alright. So I don't really necessarily need to close this in. I should make some sort of access. I might dig this out off camera and make some access to it. So I can get in behind. And I need a facade for that. And then cover this in like that. I don't need this. What else? Let me just leave it like this. I want to leave that window there, just because. And now I'm going to go upstairs and put a roof on this thing. And I'll be right back. Are you serious right now? Where did he come from? Greasy. Greasy. Alright. Alright. So maybe he actually helped me out a little bit. Probably not, but need to put. We got to put some capacitors in. You can get out of here, can you? So as you can see, I put water in there. That should, I was gonna put a water break, but I figured if they land in a pit of water, that's fine. Yeah, capacitors. I'll put, I don't think I need two. I'm just gonna put one like here. Put one there. There. And then, oh, my inventory is stocked. I'll go like this. I wonder if he came down up from up here. That's probably what he did. I'm gonna run down along the floor so I can jump over it. And I'm gonna fill in that hole. Like this. That should be all right. I have no food on me, but I have an endless supply of potatoes, so I'm not worried about it. Put that across there like that. Oh, he blew up my portal. Which color was my portal? It was yellow, I think. Okay, put this back. Are you serious right now? Ha, take that. I don't have any glass on me. I'm just gonna cover this up for now. That backlog of items. All right, what do we got in here so far? Oh, I can't open it, dummy. Let's go like this. Nothing any good. But it appears to be working. One thing I had to do was move my solar panels because I didn't realize when I placed them, they're right under that. So if you open the interface for the solar panels, you have sun true, and this over here was sun false, which is not good. I need to go get some health. Need to ransack my garden for some potatoes. Man, I was putting that roof on the spawner, and oh man, I think I'm gonna include it in the video as like a fast forward. So you've probably already seen it, but oh man, it was getting on my nerves. I kept placing blocks on top of blocks, and I was like, oh man, I was salty doing that. I don't know why. Run, dummy. So I go down here. I have a rubber farm there now, by the way. I figured I have enough trees, so I'll get some rubber. And of course, I have no inventory space, so we don't need that. What do I have in here? We're doing pretty good on rubber. So yeah, I think that's about all that I have for this episode. Just doing the grinder in the basement. I'll work on it a little bit more off camera. I just kind of wanted to get the basics of it done. And give you a recap of what I've been working on recently. And what I'm gonna do, I think this episode, if you look in the description, you should now see a world download link. I need to go up one more. At least if I'm gonna try. If you don't see it in the description, just follow me on Twitter and I will tweet about it when I update it or when I release the download. That's only if I don't get it up in time for this video. So there will be a link to download the world, hopefully. And there will be. Oh, look, I have the glass right there that I thought I didn't have. So world download, and there will be. It's probably just going to be a link to my forum thread. And there will be a download link in there for the world. There will be config pack in there as well. I can't give you the mod pack itself because that required getting permission from like 100 different people. Maybe next time I do a mod pack, I'll do it on like Curse or something. That way, I don't. It's just permissions automatic and stuff. So, but yeah, there should be a config pack. Just have to copy the configs over to your folder, your Minecraft folder, and you'll have to manually download all the mods. So there will be a link or a post in the forum, probably the same post. Has all the information for the mods. There won't be any download links because I tried doing that before and it was just a pain to maintain because the URLs change sometimes and stuff. So I'll just pick a site. You can probably get most of the stuff on Curse, but it is 164, so maybe not. You might have to do some Googling. But try and match the same version I have in the list of files and you should be all right. The main thing is probably just the config pack that gives you all the right block IDs and stuff to load the world. So yeah, look for that in the description. And yeah, that's it for this episode. I'll see you on the next one.